I'm quite surprised by how loaded this promo is, and we haven't even looked at it yet. But this is it. We have more official teasers now for Stranger Things 4. Definitely you can tell that the series, I'm sure, is making its way soon. I think the first teaser told us that, like, I've heard this in, like, social media talk, because it's been a little while, a couple days since this trailer came out. I haven't been able to look at it yet. But I've heard it was revealed through there, or was in the last trailer we looked at. This is apparently coming out in 2022. I'm very excited for Stranger Things 4. I love Stranger Things as a show. It's a fabulous show. I mean, not perfect. No show is. But it's certainly very enjoyable. I just wish it weren't a Netflix exclusive. You know, I've been complaining, and I think rightfully so, the last couple months. I'm currently on a Netflix boycott, as much as I hate this, because I want to watch Stranger Things, but I will not break my convictions. I'm on a Netflix boycott because of the whole Mignones, aka Cuties thing. I will not pay my money to a platform that at present has that on full display and open to the general public. I'm watching that Texas indictment with very hopeful disposition, even though I wish the court case had gone through by now, but, you know, because COVID delays everything. We're in a waiting roll period, so I'm waiting for it to go through, but I'm hoping that show gets blocked pretty soon, because I want to watch Stranger Things. I want to get back on. Until then, I'm going to try and stay as far away from spoilers as I possibly can. But I'm still enjoying what I'm seeing so far with Stranger Things 4. When I get a chance to watch it, I'm sure I'll be even more excited by the long waiting and the effort I've made in terms of staying away from spoilers. Now, I will say that I've opened myself up to some of the facts that we can know about the show going in, especially with this whole Creel House thing. I'm like, what is the Creel House? So I did some digging, and I read an article on Screen Rant about some of the new developments for the show. I saw it reference this trailer and some of the content, particularly if you look at the way the article was exploring things, it did start to articulate some of the information. So I've skipped over that, and that way I can have a fresh look when I watch this. I did see that it referenced the Creel House as a significant locale for the show, as well as that apparently, and I didn't realize this, but the article at least specifies in its way that Hopper, we all knew he was in Russia, but apparently he's traveled through time. So we've made Stranger Things a bit more sci-fi and zany. Rather than having, hey, alternate dimensions, how about we time travel too? Okay, that's fine. But I'm excited to see where that goes. So I'm assuming too, by the way, this adds some clarity on the clock imagery that was in the early promo stage. I think it was in the last promo too, actually. But the earliest one for the announcement. I remember there being a clock in there. But I also noticed with that article, too, that, again, you've got a lot of casting coming here. I'll save some of the names. Actually, a lot more of the names that are coming in are referenced on a Looper article. If you want to look for more information, you can find it there. A lot of people are coming in from some very popular television shows, like Game of Thrones and Teen Wolf. A couple stars are from there. As well as, I will put this one in, Maya Hawke's brother is going to be starring here. I didn't see a disclosed role, but that's very interesting. It's like, oh, brother and sister get to maybe act together on the show. That'll be quite cool. But anyway, when it comes to the Screen Rant article, this was very interesting. Now, I hadn't seen any of the Nightmare on Elm Street films. I know they're highly respected in the horror space, at least by many fans, and probably have a huge cult following, I would imagine. Freddy Krueger, very prominent name I've heard before. Robert Englund, the actor who plays him, will be starring here, and he'll be playing Victor Creel, obviously this house being named after him. So I wanted to read from the Screen Rant article verbatim on this, because it does explore kind of what the Creel House is, in case you haven't. If you're not unfamiliar, you're like, I wonder what that means. So this is what they say. Interestingly, Victor Creel emerges as a seminal figure in Stranger Things Season 4, said to be portrayed by Robert Englund, as I said. As per the fandom's official wiki, Creel was a patient imprisoned at Penhurst Mental Hospital for a gruesome murder he committed in the 1950s. I love the fact that we're in a mental hospital, by the way. I love stories like that. That'd be a fun thriller experience. Well, thriller-horror hybrid. The official Stranger Things Twitter account announced a whole slew of characters, among which Creel's described as, quote, a disturbed and intimidating man. It is also known that Creel went blind after gouging his eyes at some point in his life, hinting that the possibility that he used to be plagued by horrific visions. So this is, like, really getting updated in terms of the scale of the horror side. But it'll be fascinating to see where this goes. I mean, we're probably going to get scarier. I'm all for it. Anyway, but yeah, as I said, I love the mental health direction when we're getting to the Penhurst side. Let's see where this, again, a lot of this stuff is new. And again, I'm not reading that entire cast list, but there are some big names coming in from what I saw. Let's go ahead and take a look at the show from a newer perspective, this being the Creel House, I think is what they call it. Yeah, the Creel House teaser. We're going to go ahead and watch this first. And we're going to talk about it more in my condensed recent while I was watching the video together. I'm so grieved this is a Netflix exclusive, by the way. I just wish some other platform had it. Because I'm like, I don't want to boycott this show. Unfortunately, I have to because I'm boycotting Netflix. It's irritating. Netflix could change this anytime. And by the way, before I know, probably some people are going, oh, you're typically against cancel culture. This isn't a cancel culture issue. The fact that it's gone through a Texas indictment. Cuties, I saw enough stuff popping up on my social media feed that I'm like, this film should be boycotted everywhere and should not be publicly visible. Okay, possibly a criminal charge should be following. Without further ado, though, let's go ahead and take a look. I wish Netflix would see sense. He's making it hard for me. Here we go. I will not violate my convictions, though. Not even for Stranger Things, as much as I love the show. It's sad. It's a beautiful house. I like the old music. The old-fashioned attire is very interesting, too. It really sets the date back. It said 1950s, so...
Children, no running.
I'm assuming that's where it's from. And the comb back hair. Again, just it all fits. Ew! Poor rabbit. Can't say we haven't seen, injured pets before. Remember the cat? From season 2. This is gonna be
fun.
Can you
maybe clarify what sort of clues we're supposed to be looking for here?
Yeah, it really feels haunted.
The world is full of obvious things which nobody by any chance ever observes. Sherlock Holmes.
It's very foreboding. And somehow the Upside Down is tying itself in. A little bit of a long wait, but fun, isn't it? Looks that way. It's just a pity that Netflix doesn't have the sense to remove projects that are sad. Anyway, I'm very excited for Stranger Things. I never get a chance to see it. I love the fact they're going like an older style mansion. And it looks like everything. Again, the comb back hair, the fashion styles, the overall painting of the house and the structure of it. It looks like an older era show. A chapter of the show. It's going to be interesting to see how this integrates because you're juggling this with the Upside Down drama and then everything going on with Russia, as we know, from like the Hopper stuff. And then we're going this direction. If they can juggle it, I'm going to be very impressed. I think they can. I think the Duffer Brothers have done a good job so far in the past 3 seasons. We'll see where this goes, but I'm really enjoying it. I love, by the way, again, you get that foreboding sense you're kind of in a haunted house. Mentally, I didn't even notice that Lucas? Here's his name, I forget. It's been a while since I've seen Stranger Things 3. It's been a couple years, right? Hasn't it? That season came out, like, way back, it feels like. The new haircut, I like it quite a bit. Everybody else looks the same though. I didn't see if Mike was here though. Where's Mike? Is Mike not in the group? I thought someone over. Yeah, he was in. I think he's here. So, oh yeah, it might be him facing backward. Or it might be Maya Hawk too. I don't know. No, I think it's Maya because you see her later, or Robin. I should specify. I don't see Finn Wolfhard anywhere in there. Huh. Where's Mike? But looks fun. I'm excited for Stranger Things 4 whenever I get to see it. Hopefully that indictment goes through. What are your guys' thoughts? I'm just like, please, just get some headway and please go my direction. What are your guys' thoughts on Stranger Things 4 so far? Let me know down below. Don't forget all of the stuff. Like, subscribe, to sharing that bell until we get to see more from the show as it unveils more details, maybe through a full trailer, whenever that happens to be. I will see you guys then. But until that point, thanks for watching this video. I love you guys. Don't forget to love yourself, your fellow man. God bless. Peace.